Hey guys, how's it going? This is William Marsh for the Sim Racing Paddock. I'm doing something a little different this time around. I think last week we actually did a live stream taking a look at Forza Horizon 4's demo, except since I was on my main sim rig, couldn't use a wheel on it, I had to use it with the gamepad. Now I have the full version of Forza Horizon 4, and I have my secondary rig right now ready with the Thrustmaster TGT, so we can actually test drive the full version of Forza Horizon 4 with a wheel. I'm excited to take a look at this, and yeah, so this does look a little different compared to what I've normally done. This is in what I call my bedroom studio, so I'm sort of going for the older school gamer muscle style stream feel. So, in a second, we will launch Forza Horizon 4 and see how this goes. So, where is it? And what the heck is going on? 1 second. Hold on, let me turn on display capture real quick. And I was driving Forza Horizon 4 earlier. And what is going on? I had it installed. Play. Product is installed. Okay. Gotta love Microsoft Store glitches. Am I right? Or am I right? Hold on a second. We can turn off display capture now. Man, streaming from my bedroom studio makes me It makes me really, really miss just streaming with triple screens. Streaming with triple screens is so convenient. Hold on, that's a little loud. Let's make sure everything is showing okay. Hold on. Is it showing for you? Hold on. Is it showing for you? Looks like it's not. So, hold on a second. Let's fix that. Game capture. Specific window. Forza Horizon 4. Okay, let's try this now. And the game crashed. First crash of the day, guys. First crash of the day. Let's play. Let's try this again. This is the Thrustmaster TGT. It's the official wheel of Gran Turismo, so we are, of course, going to play it on Forza Horizon 4. Because why not? But yeah, I was testing for about 30, 40 minutes yesterday to just make sure it worked because the Thrustmaster TGT actually did not work on Forza Horizon 3. 20 crash limit. What I found with the demo was like it crashed once or twice and then third time it worked fine. For crying out loud, Microsoft, give me a little love here. Well, third time crash. Let's just try display capture then. Display capture might drain my GPU a little more than I'd like, but should provide a smooth experience, I think. TGT is designed for PS4, but works really well on PC. Okay, that's working. Except YouTube not receiving enough video to maintain smooth streaming. Looks like we're working now. Let me know how the video quality is, though, guys. Let me know how the video quality is. I'm trying some different experimental methods for trying to work this out okay. But yeah, it looks like it's working. Looks okay. I'm just trying to make sure you guys don't get any buffering. Hey, Jimmy, how's it going, man? But yeah, see, Thrustmaster TGT works. Immediately recognizes it. So thank you for Forza Horizon 3 actually listening to us, or 4 listening to us. But yeah, it's working. Okay, let's see if this will have me redo the main race because that's what I've only done so far. Looks like it's just thrown me back. So at this point, I had just finished the first race, so I'm pulling in, and it should allow me to do the character creator. Okay, how are the audio levels? How are the audio levels, guys? And okay, first thing I would like to see, same thing as the demo. Very, very limited character templates. Where's the representation for the bald guys? Where's the representation for the bald guys? You cannot hear game sound. Okay, let's fix that real quick. I apologize for this upcoming kaleidoscope effect. So let's take a look. Not filters. I hate this wireless keyboard that I'm using right now. Properties. Focusrite USB. That's where we're having audio coming through. And let's give this a go. Okay. Are you guys hearing anything? Jimmy, I believe you went with this guy with the long, flowy hair. But I think I'll go with shorter hair, dude. At least. Character can be changed at any time at the festival or player house menus. Okay,
Hey,
audio
nice
is
to meet
good.
you.
Thanks.
I'm Kira, director of the festival. Looks
Still
like you
better
made a good
animations
impression with your
than
drumming skills.
F1
This one might have a real
2018.
chance of taking a spot on the roster. Rebecca's one of our former champions. She's giving me a hand running the Horizon Road Racing series. Excited? I remember my first day at Horizon. It's all pretty surreal, huh? I'll leave you two to get set up for the first race. Good luck. Right then, let's get you behind the wheel. Which one will it be?
I am noticing some buffering. So in the demo, we did Ford Focus RS. So let's do something else. American Muscle or Audi? Or hold on a second, let me change some settings. See if I can get a better frame rate. Okay. Hopefully this doesn't crash the game. And yep, it crashed the game. Sorry about that, guys. So I guess there's a glitch with game capture. There's a glitch with game capture in OBS, so you have to use display capture. That freaking sucks. So let's do 4200 bit rate. That should at least help. Okay. Relaunch Forza Horizon 4. Full house. Are you insulting my car? Are you insulting my car? But we'll go with American Muscle. How about? Let's go with American Muscle. And then the unskippable intro sequence we have to go through again. Yay! So let's see how this goes. We are back. P-Cars 2 and ACC. If you like GT3, ACC. If you like, if you prefer more variety, then Project Cars 2.
Okay. Do we have William here?
Well, it's looking better. Cutscenes are looking better, so bitrate might have helped. Except we have to pick our driver again.
Nice to meet you. I'm Kira, director of the festival. Looks like you've made a good impression with our talent scouts.
So I think I'll go with American Muscle.
Spot on the roster. Rebecca's one of our former champions. She's giving me a hand running the Horizon Road Racing Series.
Excited? I remember my first day at Horizon. It's all pretty surreal, huh?
I'll leave you two to get set up for the first race. Good luck.
Right then, let's get you behind the wheel. Which one will it be?
So we'll go with that Dodge Charger.
Oh my word, yes. You and I are going to get along, I can tell.
American Muscle car in Britain. Oh boy, we're going to be driving off the road. Press button 19 to get in car. Yes, this wheel has a lot of buttons.
All right, let's get you set up with a personalized okay. Bumper plate. Go on, be creative.
Let's go down to W. Because you gotta have that vanity plate. Almost there. There we go. That works. V8 versus Audi hairdresser's car. I thought the Miata was the hairdresser's car.
I expect you'll want to get a feel for your new car. So I've signed you up to some events to get you started. See you there.
Let's go to the further event first. Unfortunately, it looks like the TGT Analog 6 do not work on this wheel. A little unfortunate.
Turn left.
Well, this is pointing to the right. Yikes. Just turn off the road and we almost get hit. But let's turn off some of these assists because by default, there are some assists set up in this game. So we can go to difficulty settings. We'll do above average drive to our difficulty. And then ABS on because I don't really like these potentiometer pedals. Manual shifting. Yeah, that should work. I also want to treat this like a fun game. I don't want to just totally punish myself. So we're just going to drive past this event. We're going to go to the further of the two first. A lot of traffic here. Hopefully frame rate's smooth for everyone.
In 400 yards.
Ooh, power slide right there. So the wheel feeling is definitely better than 3. It's better than 3. Still not great, but it's serviceable.
Turn right.
Whoa. Well, rest in peace, brick wall. Woo! Almost hit someone. Oh! There goes the windshield. So, also, I just want to mention, this is on my, like, I'm gaming on my secondary system, which is using a GTX 970. And the graphics preset this is using right now is actually medium. This isn't high settings. This is just medium. So, yeah. But this is gaming 1080p, 60 frames per second, which is nice. Okay, which one is 20? Is that circle? No. Okay, it's triangles rewind. My bad. Now I gotta figure out which button's which. Which one is it? Oh, that was... Oh, it's the select button, which is the share on this wheel. Okay. There it goes.
Welcome to the Horizon
Amble Side Sprint.
Perform here and you'll be invited to more events. Perform there and someday, who knows, I might even find space for you on the roster.
Let's take a look at the starting grid. The classic muscle showcase. 70 Corvette, 69 Chevy Nova, Holden Monaro, Pontiac Trans Am, Ford Falcon. This should be a fun race. By the way, I'm sorry if I'm not addressing some of the chat messages. Because I'm on a single screen, I had to use my laptop for the chat. So it's a little less convenient for me to read the chat in this stream. So apologize if I'm missing some people's messages. Let's go on the inside. Make the car stick. Get a little power slide out, and we are good. I am getting a little stutter, but I think that's because I'm streaming, not because of just performance issues, because I've tested this on two computers, and especially this one, I didn't have a stutter when I wasn't streaming. So, yeah, life of a streamer, sometimes you just gotta put up with some stutters. Oh, that was a nice power slide through that corner. And actually could feel through the wheel this time. So I'm pretty happy with that. Got a good run out of the corner. Let's take it easy. Another switchback coming up. Whoa, 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 whoa! Lost a wee bit of control there. That was me getting a little overeager. And that's gonna cost the race. So yeah, like if you remember that Forza Horizon, they use a system called the Drivatar. So they try to give the drivers the personality and characteristics of actual people. So they analyze the data of your driving. So let's try this again, be a little more conservative and get that win. But you do have to be careful with that right pedal with this car. or else you are gonna spin. Here we go, got a run. Took sixth. Let's make a move on this Pontiac on the outside. Or is that Pontiac? Yeah. And then on this Trans Am. A little too hot into the wall. Here we go. Making a move on the Nova. I believe this is Nova. Whoa, he just ran me into the wall. Even though these races are crazy sometimes the AI isn't the best, you can always have a bit of good fun. Also, if you just imagine it's your friend. For example, ahead of me is THX5150. That is my friend Michael. He lives in Texas. So, yeah, it'd be fun to run him into the wall. If I catch him, that is. Don't want to take myself out while wrecking him, though. There we go. Run up on the inside. A little tap, bump and run, and we take the lead. Adios, Michael. Be careful here. That's where we wrecked last time. That's the win. Let's see. Yeah, Jay, I agree with that. This is a magnificent looking game, even on medium settings, like I said, I'm running on. This is just on medium settings. If I put in my other system with the 1080, run it on high or ultra or whatever, it looks amazing. And then there's also the drone mode, which apparently was also in Forza Horizon 3, I guess, but I enjoyed that quite a bit in Forza 4. Oh, Shane, that Roval race.
Wow.
It was a mix. I had mixed emotions about that NASCAR Roval race. But let's listen to this.
There's a movie shooting nearby that's in need of a stunt driver. Short notice, I know, but what do you say?
Meet me here ASAP, and I'll introduce you to Mike Steele. He's a stunt coordinator for the movie.
Okay. Stunt driver. Why not? But yeah, so.
Hey, William.
Robert, I am running on a GTX 970, and also consider I am streaming, so streaming offputs or offloads some resources of the GPU, so that's why I'm running on medium. But also, I was wanting to get to 60 frames per second, but the game automatically configured me on medium. Because this is my secondary system I'm running on. Oh, three wide. But still, this game looks amazing. The draw distance is remarkable, even for medium settings. Just would be a great game to just cruise and then go off a cliff. And then hit a tree. Thought I was gonna miss that tree. Hey, still a shortcut.
Turn left.
Whoa.
Missed it. Out there competing for a spot on the roster. So, we have new friends to welcome to the festival.
In.
Hello, friends. Now, how...
If you're using NVIDIA encoder, it shouldn't impact It gives about a 5 to 10% performance impact, NVIDIA Encoder, especially through OBS. If I was streaming through NVIDIA ShadowPlay, that would minimize any impact. But since I'm streaming through OBS, it does have that issue.
He'll do. Mike Steele, by the way. Today's shoot's a getaway scene. Head over to Broadway Village. We got everything set up there. The kid better be as good as you say.
Ah, the Veyron. Art. No, this is, I thought, right, was a Chiron.
Off to Broadway. Then step on it, yeah? We don't want to lose the light.
Okay, this thing's quick. Very touchy brakes. Whoa! Missed the corner.
You made it.
There we go.
Right. Let's get everything set up.
What happened? The game's costing more than a week's worth of wages.
You're going in at the deep end, but at least you look the part now. This is a classic car escape. The hero's being chased by a jet and escapes by jumping through an old windmill. Don't ask. If you're as good as Joel says, this should be no trouble.
Hey, okay. Remember to breathe, chased by jets, but had to jump through a windmill.
I'll talk you through it. You'll be fine.
That sounds weird. Well, let's see how this goes.
Hook it left, but keep your foot down. Cue pursuit vehicle.
Harrier jet,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, the baddies in a jet plane. So what? You just keep that needle in the red. Maybe do some evasive maneuvers. And the baddies overshot you, and your hero is safe. For now. Good. This is all good stuff.
Whoa. Okay, lift off, oversteer. Galore in this car.
Still got the jump to do.
Okay, one more turn.
So you're gonna cut across the field. They'll add something in post. Crashed alien ship or something.
I thought they said cut across the field. I guess it means the next corner. Let's try it again.
It's all marked out for camera coverage, okay? You just line it up, floor it, and pray.
Okay, that's what they're talking about. Oh, this is gonna be cool. Oh, there's a sheep!
Hey, eyes forward! Ignore the camera. Try to look heroic. And that's
try to look heroic.
Rat, everyone. Congratulations, kid.
They should have had a cutscene there or something.
Do that again? I'll give your number to casting. Call you if there's another job.
Well, 3 stars, I'll take it. But yeah, it's interesting. That's one of the reasons I like Horizon. It's those absurd challenges. It's those absurdities that just makes it fun. It's like the developers just decide, oh, let's not give a rip. Let's just goof off, have some fun.
Hey, William. Hey. There's a lot of rumors flying around that you've landed a spot in a new movie. Make sure you save time to take part in the autumn season when you're rich and famous.
It would be interesting if later in the game you got to actually see that scene.
Hello, I'm Anna, your automated
Anna! She makes
a
return.
I'll help you explore the festival and find activities throughout the UK.
Was it named Anna in Horizon 3?
I have set your route to a new race in the Horizon Road Racing series.
Okay. Liking the music though. Check out some of the other stations. Bass Arena.
Turn sharp left.
And oh, Sean Cole just surpassed. Well, virtual Sean Cole. Oh, that hurt. Threading the needle. But yeah, I'm enjoying this. It's fun to just unwind, relax, goof off. Which kind of is the point. Is Gamer Muscle's house in the game? Oh, it's 300 yards. Okay. Still a little behind.
You have arrived at your destination.
Scenic handbrake stop. See the generic NPC models just dancing? Yep. There we go. He's in that shed over there. Yeah, this is pretty fun so far. Let's take a look at the tuning menu, though. So, car tuning. Basically, always the same in Forza games. I'm going to stiffen the rear anti-roll bar, though. Maybe get the rear end to step out a bit, some slide. Interesting. Oh, okay, so rear, yeah, that makes sense. You wouldn't be able to change rear downforce. Braking force. We were having some issues, so... Let's turn to 85. Apply setup. Sean Cole in the Corvette. He would be in a Datsun Z with a V8 swap, though. He used to have one of those. Little bump. Little bump never hurt anyone. Draft. Take the inside line for next corner. Oh, car in front getting a little squirrely. That's Michael, THX5150. My friend AJ, DangerMan100. He is in the Mustang. Little pass in the grass. Oh, that was a hard lick. Whoa. Mulligan. I know some people are going to go mad because I am using the rewind. It's a game. Let's have fun. Power slide into the inside line for the lead. It's these moments that you just are like, yep, we're having fun. Oh! Tap the grass a little bit there. There we go. One more gate, checkpoint, whatever you want to call it in, we get the win. Jay, that is an accurate statement. Yep, that was fun. And hey, this car setup changed. Made it a little more tail happy, so hey, I don't mind. That was pretty fun.
Can you amuse yourself until then? You've caught the eye of Alex, one of our Horizon superstars. He's looking for new racers to take part in the Dirt Racing Series.
Dirt Racing Series. We did test this out in the demo, the Dirt Racing Series, so I'll do a different car for the full version. But yeah, hey. I'm enjoying this with a wheel. I mean, it is not perfect. It's not on a simulation caliber, but hey, we're having fun, even though I am also driving on a 7-year-old TV now with a lot of input lag. I'm still enjoying it. It's still fun. That's the point. Have fun, goof off, throw a car down a cliff and still race. Race against a jetliner or a fighter jet? Why not? And hey, still semi-believable physics. That's one of the cool things. Semi-believable. And just crap load of cars to cruise around. Really does remind me of, say, like the test drive Unlimited days. Force feedback's pretty good. Force feedback is decent.
Some new tires. Come and see me after the race if you need anything else.
Ah, it's you. I heard about the stunts you pulled for Joe.
So yeah, now we get a rally pedigree car, I'll say.
Speaking of which, you'll need a car that can handle the dirt.
So, in the game, I believe we took the Subaru last time. But we also have the Ford Escort RS Cosworth. But I think I'm going to go for the Lancia. Lancia just has a great look to it.
Solid pick. You obviously know your stuff.
Rally Charger. Are you had to pick one of the three cars? Get in the car. I mean, I bet you could tune it. I bet you could tune the Charger to be a rally car, but it wouldn't go well, I bet.
Okay, first dirt race coming right up. You go and enjoy yourself out
there. All right. This should be fun. Oh wow, I just totally missed the start. I was reading the chat and I got caught sleeping. So basically gonna take a miracle for me to get the lead. And maybe some clever ingenuity. Throw it in. Here we go. It's races like this, which I wish I had my handbrake set up. Breaks a little bit there. Lap one done. Ooh, that was a big jump. Come on, we gotta push. Here we go. Big move. All right, we are right behind fake AJ, so let's try to make a move. Oh, little contact. Final lap. Okay. Crash through a wall of rock and no damage? Well, I also have damage set to cosmetic. Damage is set to cosmetic only. Can we pass all these cars? Make a move on the outside for the lead. Don't overcook the corner. But hey, we went from literally missing the start to taking home the win. There we go.
Yes. First race in the bag. How do you feel? Dirty.
This is supposed to be fun arcadey game, but with believable physics. So think like the Dirt 3, Dirt 4 type driving experience. That's what I sort of get from this.
Perform like that again and you might just make it into round two.
As I mentioned, it's a believable driving experience. It's not meant to be the hardcore realism.
Remember, the more driving you do,
if you want that, buy Lift for Speed and go into a cruising lobby.
Fancy winning a prize?
We get the wheel spin.
Here, have a wheel spin.
What do we win? 45,000. I almost got the RX-7, and that would have been Jimmy Broadbent's dream car.
I'm hearing good things about you. Oh, sorry, my name's Jay. I might have something that'll interest you. There's a street race meetup, and I think you should check it out. See you there?
So, there's... what is that thing? Fast travel board, we don't need to worry about that. I have steering set to, standard. I'm not a fan of the simulation steering, but we can give it a try. So if we go to difficulty settings, let's jump into, where is it? Steering simulation. Why not give it a try? Maybe they've improved it.
200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Well, Full House, one thing to consider is that this game isn't marketing to the hardcore simulation demographic. It's them looking for a polished racing game just where you can have fun. And that's one of the ways I'm looking at evaluating it as. It's a racing game where you can have fun. Let's jump through that lighthouse again, because we can.
All right, my name's Mal. I'm one of your DJs for the Horizon Festival. They gave me excess when I was at the rock station, apparently.
Wasn't
gonna do it, you know. I think rock music.
That did not go nearly as well as in the Bugatti.
Good car to get to work in and a big stack of records.
If you press T, you can get a telemetry screen.
This could be a lark. So you're coming along for the ride?
Oh, that's cool. And then you can Let's see. If I guess I was using a better supported telemetry, or not better support telemetry, better supported wheel, I think it would be nice to go through the different options. But it's cool seeing this, seeing that option. So, handbrake!
You have arrived at your destination.
There goes the field. You can cycle through the pages with your mouse. Okay. Yeah, that's a little bit too multitasky when you're using actual wheel. Only so much you can do. But hey, head-to-head race.
You ready? Ready?
Ferraris. Unfortunately, we're not driving either of them. D-pad doesn't work.
Oh, it's you. You made it. I'm Jay, by the way. Alex wouldn't shut up about you, you know. If you drive half as well as he says you can, these guys will love you. Oh, before we start, you've got to know this isn't strictly sanctioned by the festival. So don't mention this to Kira, all right? I gotta go. Work to do.
Gotta love that dude's hipster haircut.
Though, yeah?
It's like just total
official,
hipster.
But you keep coming to these meets, I'll make sure everyone at Horizon knows your name. Looking forward to seeing what you can do out there. Have fun now, yeah?
We are getting stacked up against, it looked like a BMW? Or no, okay, it's an actual 12-car race. From that cutscene, it looked like you were meant to just do a head-to-head, one-on-one. Throw the car in. Whoa! Okay. That's a brake lockup. I want to check something real quick. Wait, not exit. No, not that. Okay. Settings. Control settings. What button is advanced? Let's adjust this. So space is... Or let's see. Advanced. So. I want to make the... deceleration axis. Where is that? Dead zone, inside and outside. I'm looking for linearity, which apparently they might not have, unfortunately. Let's up the dead zone. Well, that's unfortunate. I would have loved an option for a brake linearity option. Make the brake non-linear. So, we'll at least do this. Checkpoint missed. Thank you. Got a little preoccupied. Still, it just locks up like none other. Or at least triggers the ABS. As mentioned, I'm not a fan of the Thrustmaster T3 PAs. Need to start making some moves. Cut some draft off of Darren. There we go. Pass on the inside to Michael. Adios, AJ. Sean Cole in the lead. Not for long. Dang it. Come on. Now we just gotta catch a slipstream if we can. Ah, Sean. AI difficulty is harder than average, apparently. Like, or above average, or so whatever it was. Wait. Unspoken rules about respect and honor. That's Sean's avatar. That's funny. Anytime. This is the Thrustmaster TGT. That is Sean's... That's funny. I don't know if he has actually driven this and he chose that icon to be funny, or if that's just what was randomly assigned to him, but either way, that is funny.
Hey, just to let you know, there's another round.
Next round of the dirt racing.
If you fancy it. See you there. Oh, and me and Jay have just finished setting up a new danger sign. You should check it out if you fancy some thrills along the way.
Danger sign. Looks like a jump. The resemblance is uncanny. Especially the cowboy hat. Throw the car into the slime. That feels like a mini rally course in itself. Here's the jump.
You have arrived at your destination.
Full speed ahead.
These were boarded up to mark potential hazards.
Well, that landing just totally destroyed my windshield.
Voila, a danger sign is born. So long as you survive, they'll probably let us build more.
Well, I guess we barely survived. So I'm guessing if we had simulation damage on, that could have actually hurt the car. Handbrake turn.
Turn right. Turn right. Turn right.
Turn right. Turn left. Oh, didn't actually say it this time. That's the way to enter into a race. So I'm going to modify the setup for this car a little bit. I want to see if we can tune down the brakes to try to actually keep from locking up. We'll do 70%. And then difficulty settings. Damage and tire wear set to simulation. God help us all. Barely made that checkpoint. Oh! That was a little hard impact. Looks like Darren out, move on the inside, and we get the spot. One lap in the bag. Whoa! Okay. Minor retaliation. Whoa! Overcooked that turn. And Sean is just pulling away again. We can't let that pink cowboy hat wearing whatever take the win. I think we just murdered a chicken. Okay, I got a little too caught up by the chicken, but let's rewind. Okay, the chicken is no longer there. Rewinding saved a... Okay, I know people don't like rewinding, but if we can save a chicken's life by rewinding time, we will do it. Yeah, I keep on missing that corner. Come here, you chicken nugget. Whoa! Okay, we just murdered the chicken again. Whoa, chicken nugget did not survive the second time. I guess that's time correcting itself. And there's Sean Cole's victory dance again. Guess Sean's compensating for no hair. Ah. I'm having so much fun right now.
Good news is you've made the cut for the Horizon Autumn season. Bad news, obviously, is that it doesn't start until autumn. You don't mind sticking around, do you?
Hey, I owe you big time for helping me out earlier. Meet me here. I want to repay your favor.
Oh, is this like the house thing that we're about to go to? Player house discovered, okay.
Introduce me to the lady who runs the road racing here at the festival. She's dead good, isn't she? Some of the managers I've had couldn't get us a gig if they're...
I'm enjoying the game with the wheel. I'm actually enjoying it. It's not as tight in terms of handling compared to other titles, but it's better than three. It's better than three. I'll give it that. Woo! That was close, close, close. Save it, save it. There we go. That was close. But yeah, get a decent idea on what the car's doing, the handling, and just overall what you are experiencing driving-wise. And you even feel the bumps through the wheel, which is nice. Granted, I've only tested so far with the Thrustmaster TGT. This does not work with an open sim wheel. I've tried. I can't get it working. Unfortunate, but yeah. Full house. I'm not going full on Ronald McDonald murdering any animal I see. Gonna jump? Nope. Just crest. But yeah, turning down the brake sensitivity really did help. Whoa, that was close.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
There we go. Quick transportation.
You've arrived at your destination.
You're not gonna believe this. The film producers bought this house to use as a set. But when filming wrapped, they just left it. I had a word, and you know what? They said you could have the house for free.
Yeah, like you could.
For your work on a movie.
Getting a free house in the UK. Sure, seems legit.
Excellent. Well, since this one's on the movie,
be sure to read the fine print saying it sold your soul.
If nothing else, you can store your threads here. Your wardrobe is like a map of your career. So the more you get yourself out there, the more clothes you get in return. Speaking of which, I see you've already made a name for yourself before coming to Horizon UK. So I ordered in some exclusive threads as a thank you.
Yeah, you only get a hoodie. Eh, let's just do that. It works. As continued support inspires us to keep making great games. Okay, well, that works. Where are the cars? They just said I got some free cars. Okay. That's funny. Now we get them. Why not hop into Ford? They gave me a Raptor, yep. So here's, I guess, the Auto Vista, which you can't really do with the... you can't really do with this wheel? Okay. So peaceful, but now it's going to fall. Or autumn.
Well, we're committed to the autumn season. You are this close to qualifying for the next round of the Dirt Racing Series. You should come back to Tarnhouse, it's completely different in autumn.
Massive map, though. We need to do some cruising. It's gonna make you send an event there, though.
Hey, William. We've added some more stations to your radio. If you're into drum and bass, then tune into Hospital Records. And if you're into something much calmer, Timeless FM is back with a healthy dose of classical. In 400 yards, turn left.
It always just cracks me up how a lot of racing games, they'll do classical music. But yeah, whoa! Okay, that was a Mini Cooper that I guess got murdered by a Drivatar. So you can feel the car sort of step out a little more because of the rain. Would have liked to see puddles or something like that, but... yeah. It's pretty cool seeing the dashboard for this car. Oh, there's a puddle.
Turn right.
But yeah, there's also classical music in Burnout Paradise, which just would always crack me up. You just see cars getting ripped to shreds to Beethoven. Whoa! Well, I am hoping that the UK stonemasons, they have good insurance for the Horizon Festival, because we're just blowing right through them. Whoa! Okay. They were just racing side by side, I guess. Wow. That's the exterior sound they decided to go with for the Mustang. Yeah. I've actually never driven a Mustang myself in real life, but I can definitely say it doesn't sound like that.
Same course, totally different drive.
So, Mustang rally car, why not? Muscle car rally. Whoa, okay, yeah, that's different. Totally different driving feel. Taking a lot more effort not to spin. Actually, no! Well, rest in peace, tree. How much does this game cost in the USA? Standard edition is $59. Ultimate edition, which I have, is $99. And that includes all the expansion passes that are planned for the game. It, I guess, allows you to have early release, so you can play it earlier. It includes other bonus content as well. I should have changed my car. Really should have. I mean, this thing will slide. Here we go, making a move. Barely made that checkpoint, and I didn't get bumped, it was just I got too eager with the throttle. What cracks me up, all the muscle cars are struggling, but the smaller compact cars are the ones in the lead, so I would consider that fairly realistic. Here we go. Third place. At least Sean's not gonna win this one. Too much horsepower. Yep. That's why I'm saying I should have switched my car. The Raptor would have been fun for this race. not smart from me. I should have not hit that puddle. Here's my chance. Nose to nose. Woo! We get the win. There we go. That was not a choose our way. Yeah, that's a 17 thousandths of a second gap. I'll take it. We're up to level 3.
Oh, we'll have you in round 2 of the Dirt Racing series. Thank you very much. It doesn't matter if you've already done this route. The fans will keep coming back for more. You'll get noticed, and it'll help you qualify.
We get the super wheel spin.
It's a win-win.
Hey, William. If you liked the Horizon wheel spin, wait till you try the Horizon super wheel spin. Same principle, but you get 3 prizes instead of 1. Plus, a higher chance of winning something really special.
Melon leggings. Melon leggings.
Hey, William.
Flamehawk, Assetto Corsa on wheel. Assetto Corsa on wheel.
My team are helping me find our most influential rookie to compete in the next showcase. Want it to be you? Convince me. Beck tells me you're in round 2 of the Road Racing Series. And Joel mentioned that someone named Mike Steele is after you about a stunt.
What the heck? Let Forza access my microphone. I don't need that. So,
well, actually, what are you waiting for? Yes.
Why not? Melon leggings are essential to racing. Okay, so let's go into settings.
Just letting you know, the
You have a VIP pass, do you? Well, the house is yours. Right this way. Let me show you around.
We get a second free house.
Auto show is now open. Come on down and browse.
Hold on. New content added to my profile. New cars added to the garage. Oh my gosh. What? We might have to take that for a spin. Or are these cars we can purchase? Or okay. Or FBI needs to be more sneaky.
Or I can send the catalog to your house if you prefer.
Okay, so you guys were asking about it. So, Horizon Life, I guess. What is that? Oh wait, do we get more wheel spins? I wish this made a little more sense, but let's take a look. Super wheel spin. Yes, we get 3 more super wheel spins. What the? Come on, car, car, car. Oh my god. Chicken suit? We're gonna have to check that out. This seems so weird. I guess some wheel spins came with the Ultimate Edition or something. But yeah, we'll have to test out that chicken suit. Two more spins. Come on, money, 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 or big car, nice car. 150,000 credits, I'll take it. And a green flat cap.
You look sharp in those. You can head home to change if you like, or just do it here at the festival site.
So.
Great news! I've found a driver for our first showcase event. A rookie, no less. Unproven, but highly skilled. Huge potential. I think they're going to make this one to remember. So, you doing anything
right
now? Hoverboat
race, I guess. Except, I had something else to do.
And around when it is safe.
So, world map. Was going to navigate to the new house. There we go.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Car coming.
You've earned a skill point.
Guess not. I thought there was one.
You can use your skill point here to unlock car mastery experience. Every car has its own set, offering unique perks and bonuses. But skill points can be spent on any car you own.
And there are barn finds soon. Yes. Should be exciting to check out the barn find. Okay, you have to unlock one perk first. And then you can unlock other ones. And okay. Funny glitch. Because we were driving through the puddle right when it took us out, those drops are stuck. That's funny. But yeah, driving a Porsche on a rally course. Actually, we're gonna take the jump.
Recalculating route in 200 yards.
Okay, that looked like it was gonna sting a bit. Still haven't seen any sheep yet. Come on, it needs to start raining so I can clear this windshield. Speed camera, I guess, coming up.
Credits
for speeding. Usually you lose credits while speeding, you don't gain credits. For Horizon, they should have a cops and robbers mode someday. That would be a lot of fudge! Well, that's one way to clear our windshield. Should be able to go to the auto show to get the DLC cars. Yeah, I think they said the auto show just opened up, so we'll check it out shortly. Enjoying the music with this game. Generally, I'm not a huge fan of this kind of music, but it works well with the game.
yards. Turn left.
But yeah, it's nice seeing that this is a nice, big, open world. It has a lot of variety to it. One of my main complaints with Forza Horizon 3 was it just felt kind of dull scenery-wise. And this feels a lot more dynamic, it feels a lot more engaging, a lot more fun. As I wreck into a house. We'll get into the chicken suit, I promise.
You have arrived at your destination.
View the house.
Here we go. House and grounds.
Free with VIP.
You can sit in the front room and watch.
Oh, you get five super wheel spins because of this.
That is assuming I don't have to help a stranded driver in the middle of the lake again. Not gonna lie, I'm pretty jealous of that.
Kind of funny. I think we kind of murdered a chicken and now we get a chicken suit. That's kind of karma. So. If we. Oh, DLC cars. That's where you can pick some up, I guess. So. Where do you change customized character? Outfit. Oh my gosh. Then you get Bond suits. Disco chicken suit. Unlock through select team adventure series rewards. Okay. That is amazing.
You any good at dancing? You can bust a move to show off before a race and bust an even bigger move for when you win. Trust me, it'll be great.
Ay, that dance has to stop. We'll just do this. Dancing chicken suit. Okay. Well, I hope you're happy. And DLC cars, let's take a look. Best of Bond. Some nice cars. Formula Drift Pack. Cool options. Don't really see any jumping out at me right now. Yes, I have a lot of cars now. Oh, wait, these are also. Oh, that's buy car? Okay, so that's the marketplace, I guess. So, garage, my cars. That's. Okay, that makes sense. We gotta try this. A chicken driving a PLP 50. Okay, so barn finds not available yet. Let's get this thing and drive.
Yes! You're really nailing all of those speed traps, aren't you? Don't stop now. I'm just getting started.
We gotta actually race this van. Whoa. But you can see the chicken suit. You can see the suit's hands.
Oh,
This is just making me go, what the heck? Fifth gear, 95 miles an hour in a transit van.
Turn left.
What cars are they gonna have me racing against, though? Oh my gosh, okay. So I guess we're actually online with people. If we're seeing actual cars. This thing handles great though. Unrealistically great, but still fun. There are tunes for this build, I can imagine.
What's up, Horizon? It's your friend Amy Simpson here. Now, I've been on the phone with Alex Strachan about our dirt racing series. He's really excited about how round one went down and looking forward to seeing how round two unfolds. But what he actually mainly talks about.
I wonder, will a handbrake turn flip the car? No, it won't.
You're welcome, Alex. What's next on Pulse?
Awesome view, though. Can't fault that view.
You can race any event in co-op or PvP with drivers you invite from your session. Hey, William. Let's take a look at Horizon Blueprint. This is something I let our old festival boss play around with in Australia, but they're not here. So I need to see if we have any fresh blueprinting talent.
I bet that skin has great grip.
Blueprint lets you choose where and how fast. But first, cars. Every blueprint needs a car theme.
Vans and utilities.
These are curated by the techs in the auto show to keep things competitive and interesting. If nothing takes your fancy, you can even create your own. Now you need to set a car class. Slow or fast, small engines to large, or set open class for a real free-for-all. Last few touches, then we can get your blueprint named and published. Now for a name. We need it for the records. And you know, it has to sound cool. Everything finalized? Once that's done, we can move to testing. Congratulations! Your first blueprint event. And the honor of being the first driver to run it goes to you. Show them how it's done.
That chicken. That chicken. So let's see how this goes. Trying to draft. Wait, this car has 7 gears. I did not realize that. Here we go, starting to make up ground. Oh! Oh! Retaliation. Race in a hearse. Okay. That's one way to make a move. Stick the corner. There we go. And it's Sean in the lead again. Interesting though, it's showing a normal person in the car, not pink cowboy hat. Oh, I was stuck in max RPM. My bad. Let's see if we can catch Sean into corners. He just has the power right now. Nope. Sean's gonna take the win. We'll get second though. And watch, it'll be purple chicken suit. The resemblance to Sean is uncanny. Level 5. Fist pump emote. Let's see what we get in this wheel spin. I just wonder how much fun they had just making these weird combinations. Horizon,
so I'll be taking the fastest qualifiers through after each round and eliminating the rest. Welcome to round 3.
Here's how this is going to work. We're not sanctioned by the festival. We make our own rules. The best racers stay and the rest go home. This is the street scene. I mean, if that's cool with everyone.
Let's switch the vehicle out. Change car. Ooh, Zonda. Let's give this a go. Hopefully it sounds okay. Force feedback's okay. Oh my god, this sounds horrible. This car sounds horrible. Okay. Nothing like the real thing. Nothing like the real car. But yeah, it seems like some of the cars just have horrible sounds. I mean, like, abysmal. But, yeah, I mean, that's kind of been the case with Forza at times. K-Dog, this is actually not the GT Omega. It's the Next Level Racing FGT cockpit. And I'm enjoying it quite a bit. It's pretty stable. It's solid. I'm enjoying it. So, yeah, it's not the... it is not the GT Omega. This is the Next Level Racing. Let's get into this. At least this Ferrari sounds relatively close. Let's do another jump.
Crazy enough.
More than crazy enough. I have not tested the car, and I have not gotten the GT1 Evo yet. They said they're waiting on a couple parts before sending it. Let's go to the map. This is a massive map, though. That's a cross-country race. Why not do that in a Ferrari 458?
When it is safe to do so.
Well, that's not turning around. Whoops. This car is beat up now. This car, handling is okay. Very tail happy, though. That was my mistake, though, causing that spin. Wouldn't be surprised if something's damaged in this car. Still tracking straight, though. But yeah, high speed. It seems like this car really wants to spin, I guess. Low downforce, I guess. I get points for spinning out, okay. Mark 13. We are in a chicken suit. We are in a chicken suit. That's what the heck those hands are. We won a chicken suit, so we're in the chicken suit. Whoa, okay. Yeah, I'm guessing because these cars are ghosting, that means we're in an online lobby. I wonder if there's a way to... Or no, does it force you to be in an online session? That's interesting.
Yards, turn right.
Shouldn't you say chicken pox hands?
Turn right.
Love seeing that waterfall there. I saw it in the demo, saw it here. Cool to see that waterfall. Looks better in higher settings, though. Beauty spot. What do I think of how it feels so far? Feels pretty good. It feels solid. There's the dancing chicken on top of the waterfall. I'd say it's not as tight handling-wise as, say, like Assetto Corsa, things like that, but... It's believable driving. I'd say similar to the Dirt 4, Dirt 3 handling.
Just for doing some stunt driving in a film. I mean, wow, fair
play to the driver. I'm sure they were great, but hello, Amy Simpson here. Where was my audition? I can do a three-point turn and reverse around a corner. Somebody come and give me a free house.
My thoughts exactly. You usually don't get a free house for doing a stunt drive. Unrealistic. I have not tried the Crew 2 yet. I haven't. I have a key for the Crew 2, but I haven't tried it yet.
Turn left.
Cross country the event, eh? So now we get a new car.
Ah, I was wondering when I'd see you for my cross-country series. I was starting to think you wouldn't show up. Hey, before we kick off...
Broken Vert, no issues whatsoever. It recognized everything. No issues whatsoever. We're going to have to go with the Baja Bug.
Aye, should handle the conditions nicely.
Excuse me. I did take the bug. Jack, I'd say yeah. I'm enjoying the game. Don't go in expecting hardcore sim, because that's not what it is. Go in expecting a fun game. And expect dancing chickens. And guys, remember, if you want to add me, I believe I have my... I have my gamer tag in the description for Xbox Live. It is BlazingGlory53. So, if you want to add me, you can look in the description for my name. So, yeah. I'm going to detune the brakes again because of the... crap T3PA pedal linearity, whatever you want to call it. 60% should be fine. Apply it. Yes. And then run the race. GT Sport needs dancing chickens. In the demo, I never got hit with a copyright claim, so... I'm hoping I'll be okay for the actual game. Whoa, losing it. Caught it. Those are hay bales. We're in last place. We gotta make some moves. Big jump. Jump over the car to make the pass. Yeah, buddy. No bueno. Rewind. Barely made that checkpoint. Making our move. This kind of track reminds me of Monster Truck Madness, where it's the cross-country courses. I think it was Farmland 129 in Monster Truck Madness 2. That's what this is reminding me of. No! Sixty percent done with the race. We took a couple Mulligans, but we have a shot. Dang it! But yeah, Monster Truck Madness, one of my first ever racing games I played as a kid, and it was so much freaking fun. I want to do a video highlighting it later on. I want to do a series talking about titles that resulted in my love for sim racing. And dang, that corner's just getting me big time. Mark, I did experience a couple game crashes, but I think it was because of a conflict between NVIDIA, OBS, and the game. Because whenever I would try to do game capture and use that function in OBS, the game would crash. So now we're just doing display capture and it's working okay. I am getting some frame stutters, though. You can see that, though, but that's because of OBS's game capture, and yeah, little unpleasant. We are sucking this race, though. I think we chose the wrong car. That hay bale killed me. So I'm going to change a couple things, actually. Actually, I'm going to retry this event with standard handling. Because I'm not a fan with the simulation handling in Forza games. They try to make it almost too responsive, in my opinion, and it ends up turning out too snappy and causes issues. So, we'll go back to normal, where I feel like normal handling is more authentic than simulation handling. Officer is not cool. I'm using a GTX 970 in this build with a Ryzen 7 1800X. So let's try this again. Love this jump here. It won't fix stupid driving, though. We're in last place again. Off-road handling is legitimately challenging in this game, though. I'll say that. We just knocked down a tree. Same corner and we missed the checkpoint. This corner's killing me, man. Just having a weird frame stutter right there. That was a major slowdown. So it seems like it's more hardware intensive off-road than on-road. We're driving through a soccer field, or football field as they call it too. I don't know what happened, it just got so much worse right now, frame rate wise. I think it's because I'm streaming. I do not know what song this is. Hey, yeah, bad race happens. This almost sounds like Katy Perry. Come on, I want to do a barn find.
Satellite maps for barns around the festival, and I found
okay.
What? I mean, statistically, there's a decent chance there's a classic car in it, right?
So, after this barn find, I think I am gonna sign off for the stream. a couple things that I need to do today, but yeah, so far, first impressions of the full version of Forza Horizon 4, a lot of fun. The stuttering issue is not representative of what I've been getting gameplay wise. It's because of streaming. It's because of streaming that it's just allocating a lot more system resources and causing the stuttering. So yeah, in most of my testing so far, it's been just fine. It's been fine frame rate wise, rock solid 60 frames per second, great performance, beautiful visuals, decent handling. With a wheel, I would have liked it to be a little better, to be honest. With a wheel, I would have liked it to be a little more refined, but it is a solid improvement over the Horizon 3 force feedback. So there's one thing I want to try, though. I want to check settings real quick. And, or wait. Yeah, so control settings. And if I go to wheel, is there an option for me to have... Hold on. Let's see. Yeah, I'm not seeing an option for analog sticks, unfortunately, but if I go to controller... I will be doing more streaming of this. I was going to try out the drone mode. Let's see.
Have you got it? Kira said she was sending it over. You have? Yes.
Okay, that didn't work.
It's a perfect.
So let's just do the barn find the normal way, old fashioned.
Can I have a play with it, please?
I was going to do the drone to see if I could find the barn, but that did not work. But I will do more streaming in the future of this. I do want to like update my drivers and everything, try to get sorted out, but yeah, I will do more streaming of this. Big jump. So yeah, barn find, same as Forza Horizon 3. You cruise around an area trying to find a barn. Looks like there's the barn right there. That's a house. Is she on the back? Not seeing a barn there. So it could be further off. Let's see if we can climb this. Hill climb car! The little Baja bug that can? Come on, come on, come on, come on! So close! Alright, Shane, sounds good. Climbing a mountain. In a Baja bug. Let's see, do we have a vantage point? Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Almost rolled it. Ooh, is that it to the right? That's kind of funny. They kept the kangaroo stunt in, even though this is no longer in Australia.
It's Horizon Pulse.
Ooh, that's barely too far out. That's not the
Horizon,
barn.
Listen up. It's time for another newsflash, ranked in order of importance. Here we go. Congrats
Let's see.
Our road racers on advancing to round three. The big Pulse party tonight is kicking off at 7 p.m. sharp. And there is a new taco truck just behind the main stage.
Now, a new taco truck.
Or descending order
digital tacos. $5 DLC. The barns have a cylinder shape. Wait. Thought I just saw a deer. Okay. Let's go up this road and see if we can find anything. You would have thought they would make the first barn find easier to find. But yeah, we're doing some mountain climbing and a bug. There's something at the top. Yeah, I wanted to use a drone to find it, but I can't map the controls. Oh, that's a fast travel board.
So, Kira told me about these. Smash a fast travel board and you'll get a discount on the Horizon fast travel service. Smash them all and the festival will cover your costs completely. Good to keep in mind for our many adventures.
Oh wait, that looks kind of run down. That's not cylinder shape, but that looks run down. Oh, that is cylinder shape. Found it!
Found it? What did I tell you? Be right there.
And I'm... Escort Turbo RS. Man, that car's beat up.
Whoa, check it out. Escort RS Turbo, nice. Some 17-year-old boy loved this thing to death. Probably before I was even born. Let's get it back to the garage.
Don't worry. If there's any hoon left in it, we'll find it.
Alrighty. So, on that note, I am going to sign out. But yeah, guys, initial thoughts? I'm enjoying it a lot. It's fun to drive. It has a nice open world, a lot of variety, which... was one of my complaints about Forza Horizon 3. Didn't have much variety. So seeing Forza Horizon 4 with more variety, I like it. It's more the same though, so I don't go in expecting a radical departure or something like that. Expect a fun open world racing game. And with semi-believable physics. This is definitely not Sim, but it's a fun game as we are about to die. Ow.
Okay, that's not it. Street scene is sanctioned.
That hurt.
Definitely not that.
But yeah, so expect a fun racing game, and I don't think you'll be disappointed. So yeah, this game comes out tomorrow, I guess. But yeah, I've been enjoying it. It's a lot of fun. Cool cars. Somewhat difficult handling at times, which is pretty nice. But yeah, guys, this is a lot of fun so far. I'm planning on doing more streams in the future of this, so yeah. Until then, I'm Will for Sim Racing Paddock. This guy's in a chicken suit, and we both will see you later on.